thank you so much. He's giving me these checks, so I'm going to see how fast y'all can come and get them. All right. We thank God for every parent, every child that made an application, and we would do our little spiel. The rest of our little spiel is before we present to you a check. But at this time, I'm going to turn it over to our chairperson. Let's give her a hand. Kimberly.
Oh, morning, or just say good afternoon. Let us bow our heads. Lord, thank you for allowing us to travel here safely and come soak up and emulsify ourselves in your teachings. We thank you for giving us the opportunity to bless these deserving young people with gifts, to give them support and advantages, not just through finances, but through your word as well. Bless them so they can continue to persevere and chase after their dreams in your name and on your account. Amen.
Amen.
Offices, Scholarship Committee, Scholarship Recipients, Families, Connectional AME Members, Smyrna Church Family and Friends, everyone here, we greet you in the name of Jesus, and we're blessed to have this opportunity. To Elder Richardson and the committee who extended this invitation, I'm extremely grateful. Thank you, and congratulations to each of these scholars. Amen. Also to your families and your church families, because it definitely takes a village. My parents truly wanted to be here. I got word a little while ago that my dad was dizzy, and he drove himself to the doctor. But thank God he got home to text me and tell me that he was okay. So please keep them in your prayers.
Amen.
But I do want my Smyrna church family to stand.
Amen.
Thank you all for being here. I love you so much. And to my husband, Reverend Leverett, thank you for being here and thank you for your support. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for your help in all things, that you may be glorified today. Here is the goal. Hide me as you show up in all of your majesty and all of your glory.
Amen.
Amen.
My brief topic to you today is, this isn't about you. And it comes from Hebrews 13 and 16. If you found it, Hebrews 13 and 16, it says, do not neglect to do good and to share what you have, for such sacrifices are pleasing to God. Do not neglect to do good and to share what you have, for your sacrifices are pleasing to God. And the way the Spirit works, you're going to hear repeated a number of the same phrases that you've heard from our text earlier and from our message, Shine On.
Amen.
So that's God.
That's God. Amen.
I have three quick questions for you today, and I will get out of your way. And hopefully this won't empower just our scholars, but it will touch everyone here in some type of way today.
Praise the Lord.
My first question to you is, what would Jesus say to you today? This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. And you can read that in Matthew 22:37-39. When you replace hate with love and anger with kindness, you'll feel closer to God and notice more peace in your life. Don't for one minute fool yourself and believe that obtaining a degree is for you all by yourself. Everything that you have came from God, and He works through your parents,
yes, Lord,
your family,
thank
your
you,
church,
Jesus,
your teachers, and your community. There is a high cost to pay for everything that you receive. Because it's found in Luke 12:48. To whom much is given,
much is required. Yes.
But I encourage you to consider that more is required.
Yes.
Show love in the form of serving others. Mary Wright Ellen said, service is the rent that we pay for living. I'm already at my second question. What would Richard Allen say? The Lord was pleased to strengthen us and remove all fear from us and dispose our hearts to be as useful as possible. In the face of discrimination, Richard Allen found his own. Out of the painful life of a former slave who was separated from his family, never to see them again, he bought his freedom for $2,000 all the way back in 1783. I know you're wondering.
Awesome.
Today that would be about $44,000, and I know you wonder, where did he get that money from? But he sought to live a life that made a difference. So when he and other African Americans were no longer welcomed at the AME church or at the Methodist church, the AME church came into existence. And today, the AME church has membership in 20 Episcopal districts in 39 countries on 5 continents.
Praise the Lord.
I'm coming back to him, but I'm going to go on to my third question and ask you, what would Jerrell Lee say to you? She would say, be ready, and we heard that earlier. Richard Allen wasn't sold on the idea of women preaching, but one day when Reverend Richard Williams was unable to speak, Jerrell Lee was sitting there.
Yes.
She was sitting on a word. She had never even stood on a pulpit. She didn't know when or if she'd have an opportunity. She'd say to you when you were asked, be ready.
Yes.
Study, show yourself approved, show up and leave a lasting impression.
All right.
God can call and use anybody. We heard that today. Regardless of race, gender, socioeconomic status, don't accept anyone looking down on you or demoralizing you. Lee's zeal opened the door for other women in the ministry, and of course you know we have female bishops today. Dr. Benjamin E. May said, whatever you do, strive to do it so well that no man living, no man dead, and no man yet to be born could do it any better. Reverend Scott King reminded us that women are very important, because behind every good man, there's a good woman reminding him that she knew him when he didn't have anything. So Sarah Bass Allen, Richard's wife, was very much a partner in the ministry with him. She was feeding, clothing, and housing runaway slaves. Whatever you do, wherever you go, you can do everything, and you can do your best.
Amen.
Your name doesn't have to be called. It doesn't even have to be on the program.
That's right.
If we work to please our Heavenly Father, He knows and He sees and He rewards. So never forget
Him. Amen.
Mary McLeod Bethune is known for having said, believe in yourself, learn, and never stop wanting to build a better world. Richard Allen founded the AME Church out of love and devotion to his people. Similarly, Mary McLeod Bethune founded Bethune-Cookman College, which began in 1904. And she founded it with a very, very small amount of money. If Reverend Speed were here, I'd ask him to break it down for us. $1.50, so you can say it was 6 quarters, you can say it was $1 and some change, you can say it was $1 and a couple of nibbles, and it, I don't care how you break it down and how many pieces you make it, she didn't have any money. She was broke, basically. But she had a dream, and God gave her a vision and a plan, and that was all that was necessary. She knew our children needed a chance that no one else would give them. Fannie Lou Hamer once said, never forget where we came from and always praise the bridges that carried you over.
Amen.
The AME Church is blessing you today. Don't ever forget to look back, give back, and bless those coming back.
Amen.
When you reach your journey, send the elevator back down.
All right.
So we can carry someone else.
Come on.
So Richard Allen didn't find a place for himself only to worship, and Bethune wasn't just concerned about her and her son's education. Queen Esther in the Bible, also known as Hadassah, didn't get to the palace and forget her people.
All right.
In 2016, God spoke to me about founding Hadassah's Crown Publishing. I was doing well, living life as I knew it, going to work every day, working long hours for a system. But God had a plan, because too many publishers, traditional publishers, believe we don't read. We don't buy books. And furthermore, we can't write or even muster up enough intelligence to write a book. I didn't know where it was going. But fast forward to 2023, I'm able to live and see the vision a whole lot more. When he called me, I didn't say, well, God, well, how much does that job pay? I didn't. When I was called many years ago to become a teacher, matriculating through Clemson University, I had people laugh in my face and make fun of me many different times. A teacher, do you know what that meant? I really didn't care. And because my heart was to give and to serve other people,
was completely amazed at how many times God multiplied the mere salary that I started.
Amen.
All those years ago.
Amen.
It was less than $20,000. And some of you may say, well, how on earth did you make it? Never, ever, ever had a problem.
That's right.
Never had a problem.
That's God.
So I'm saying to you, put your purpose and your passion before your pocketbook.
Come on.
Yeah. Don't think about it.
That's right.
How many details or how few details you actually have.
That's right.
When there's an opportunity for you at their table, or if there's not an opportunity, create your own.
Mm-hmm.
As you can see, I'm not missing any meals. Psalm 37:25 says, I was young and now I'm old. Yeah. I've never seen the righteous forsaken, yes. Nor received any bread. Yes. Get to know Jesus. You've heard this.
That's right.
Learn to hear his voice and follow him and obey. Benjamin E. May said, the tragedy of life doesn't lie in not reaching your goals. The tragedy lies in having no goals to reach. It isn't a calamity to die with dreams unfulfilled, but it is a calamity not to dream. It is not a disgrace not to reach the stars, but it is a disgrace to have no stars to reach. Not failure, but low aim is the sin. And Langston Hughes said it this way, what happens to a dream deferred? Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun? Does it fester like a sore then run? Does it stink like rotten meat? Or does it crust and sugar over like a syrupy sweet? Maybe it just sags. Or does it explode? So I say to you, hold fast to your dreams.
That's right.
For if dreams die, life is a broken winged bird that can't fly. I say to you, hold fast to your dreams.
Yes.
For when dreams go, life is a bare field, frozen with snow.
Yes.
Miriam Wright Edelman said, education is for improving the lives of others and for leading your community and your world better. So remember, it's not about you. It's about all the people that you're going to serve and what that work is going to do for his kingdom. So as I leave you, I say to you, congratulations on investing in yourself so that you can improve this ever-changing world that we live in and advance the kingdom of God. Remember, your education isn't for you. You have a charge to keep.
Yes.
And a God to glorify.
Yeah. Amen.
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 Woo!
Amen.
Amen. We have the prayer for the college students. Y'all will come around the office.
Amen.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, everlasting God, God, we thank you. Father, you continually show yourself to be who you are. You're God and God all by yourself. For it is you, O God, who has made it possible for us to be here today.
Thank you, Lord.
God, we say thank you.
Amen.
Thank you for a beautiful day and all the blessings that you continually send our way. God, now we come and We acknowledge these students. We acknowledge, Father, the spirit that is within them. We acknowledge right now, Father, the call that is on their lives.
Yes, Lord.
Have mercy, Lord. Grant, O Lord God, that in those moments and times when they need someone, that they will remember that you are there.
Yes, Lord.
For you said, "Lo, I'm with you always, even to the end of the age." Father, help them to know that you are their help.
Yeah, yeah.
That you are their hope, that you have a plan for their lives. Lord God, help them know that in the times of their testing, that you are there. All they have to do is look and know that you're present. Father God, help them to know that when they go through times of valley experiences, help them to know, Lord God, sometimes they will be up and sometimes they will be down. But you are the God of the mountain and also of the valley. Help them to know, Lord God, that when they have trials and tribulations, your word has said through your son Jesus that they are to be of good cheer.
Yeah.
You have overcome the world. Let them know that they are overcomers.
Yes, Lord.
In every situation that they find themselves in, Lord God, speak to their hearts and their minds.
Yes, Lord.
Let them know that you are preparing them for what your plan is for their lives, that it is not just for them. It is not just about them, but it's about who you have called them to be in service to others. Bless the institutions where they are attending and all of the faculty members and all who are pouring into their lives. Bless them, Lord. Lord God, we pray now that you protect them. We know that we live in a world where there's danger on every side. But Father, help them to know that you're still God. And besides you, they should have no other God. Speak to their hearts. Speak to their minds. Bless their parents. Bless those who are supporting them. Bless this church. Father God, and help them to remember, Lord God, the way in which they have come. Oh, Lord God, keep your hand on them. Let them know, Lord God, that each and every moment, when they need a helping hand, you will place those persons in their way. You will place them. Let them not be anxious. But your word says by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving.
Yes, Lord.
Make their request known unto you.
Yes, Lord.
Let them know, Lord God, that we're praying for them, that we are seeking you on their behalf. Father God, help us as we continue to do what you call all of us to do. Let them know, Lord God, that they yet have a soul to save and a God to glorify. So that in those moments when they have an opportunity, as it has been shared today, to let their light shine in somebody else's life, empower them to do so. Let the Holy Spirit fill them, that they might stand boldly and share your goodness. Bless, Lord, we pray.
Bless, Lord.
All of us, Lord God, we need you right now.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name. Jesus. So I say amen.
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 Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
We'd like to thank Dr. Sumner Lever for that wonderful challenge, that wonderful message.
Elder, would you like to come up and stay down here?
No, I can. I'm going to ask the pastor if you would bring that stand, please, or have someone.
While he's doing that, let's give a hand for the best elder in the.
All right. we have before us today as we celebrate as one of our recipients, Brother Tyshon Brown. He is a member of Allen Temple AME Church. He's a junior at Charleston Southern University, majoring in aerospace management. Would you give a hand to our brother? Next recipient this day would be Greg Forsythe. He is a member of Allen Temple AME Church. He's a junior at the University of Southern California. He is majoring in BFA, Animation and Digital Arts. Would you give him a hand? Our next recipient is Brother Tyrone Garlington Jr. He's a member of Friendship AME Church. He's a sophomore at Newberry College, and he's majoring in graphic design. Our next recipient is Morgan Grant. She's a member of Mount Carmel AME Church. She's a sophomore at The Allen University. She is majoring in human services. Recipient is Allison Jackson. She's a member of Allen Temple AME Church. She is a junior at Lander University, majoring in mass media and communication. All right, you know I'm not going to get this first name correct. Jadis, all right. Our next recipient is Jadis Jefferson. She's a member of Mount Vernon AME Church. She's a sophomore at the University of South Carolina, majoring in nursing. Our next recipient is Mariah Lee. She's a member of Mount Carmel AME Church. She's a senior at the University of South Carolina, majoring in management. She's a member of Mount Lebanon AME Church, sophomore at Lander University, majoring in biology. Would you give her a hand? And my last recipient to present to you this day is Deshaun Williams. He's a member of Fairview AME Church, Anderson. He's a junior at Limestone University, majoring in exercise science. We are our would direct your attention to the screen, you'll see our scholarship donors, those that represent Allen Temple AME Church. We apologize if you can't see every name, but do know that they are celebrated because of their donations. Next, we have Poplar Spring Church, our donors. And we thank God for each and every one. We have also Mount Lebanon Church, Mount Carmel Church, King's Chapel, and Mount Zion Church Hodges. The next slide, we have the New Bethel Church, Antioch Church, Pine Grove Church, and Friendship Church. Next slide, we have Bethlehem, New Hope, Greater Trinity First, and we have those who have given towards our special scholarships. We thank God for our donors and how they have supported this endeavor. Thank you so very much.
Someone from Allen Temple. If you would please, Tasha Brown.
Jackson. Okay, Carol Garland. This is a special scholarship from the Coach Harold Williams family. Marche Lee. Okay, we have Marche. Marche had to work, she's working in Columbia, South Carolina, so she's down there. But if she's a member of Mount Carmel, I will make sure she gets it. I will see some of them today. Mr. Devin Loman. Grandmother. All right, praise God. I'm taking her tag card to give her baby. I don't have to your grandma. I'm a grandmother and I'm not proud to be a grandchildren. All right. Maya Smith. This one comes from the Greenville District AME.
Elder Richardson, to the pastors and the laity of the Greenville District, let me first of all thank you because we could not have done this without your support. And it is an honor for me on behalf of the Greenville District organization to present these two individuals, Devin Loman and Maya Smith, a $500 scholarship each from the Greenville District organization. While I'm up here, I would also like to say, children are special in my heart. I did 38 years in the school district of Greenville County, working with thousands of kids as a teacher and as an administrator. So I love kids, and I always tell the kids when we had award ceremonies, I said, you're working on those college scholarships right now. So on behalf of myself, God has blessed me, and then this year I would like to present to Miss Mariah Lee, and I know who that is, that's Marcy's daughter, and unfortunately I know she's not here today, but I would like to present her a scholarship in the amount of $500 also.
Thank you for coming out. Now, we've done an awful lot in the length of time. We had two services, and now we're actually three, and we got church groups, the workshop. So I thank God and thank you for your patience. We know that a few had to leave, but we are just so grateful for those of you that remained with us to the end. Young people, we wanted you to know who gave you the special scholarship. That's why we asked them to come up, so you can identify. So if you want to drop them a line and say thank you for making this possible for you, we feel free to do so. If you want somebody to remind you of who gave what, but most of you, I hope you remember the ones that came up anyway, that gave you this, made scholarship. Special scholarship. They were individuals that wanted to do a little something special in honor of their loved ones, and then their honor, our respect for education, and so forth. So I say congratulations, go forward, do well. You'll be, and work hard while you're in school, and you can play with it somewhere. That's what my granddaughter just told us. She graduated as a nurse from MUSC, and I've loved her mercy. Some USC, I've been to MUSC so much. I should have started, but y'all, I pray I don't have many more business days. So y'all just keep me in your prayers, keep these young people as they go forth. And please, we had other young people that could have made applications, but they said they forgot, or the pastor didn't tell them. I send it out to every pastor. Ask the Mrs. Jefferson. She is great with young people. She sent every director one. So they had two opportunities to get the application. I also say to the parents, and I say to the young people, if you do not get it from your pastor anywhere from March to June, give me a call. Now, this will be your last year. You can call me because I'm retired this year. So, but you will, I pray that it will, this scholarship program will continue. Whoever the presiding elder, I pray that they will keep it going because it's a good thing. It encourages our young people. It helps them to know that the church cares about them. Now, I hope all of you all are in church, because the pastors had to write and sign off saying you're in church. But I hope you're in church. So we don't want to like this type of preaching now. Okay? y'all can't make it bad. You can't want to get tired, get crazy. But I'm a little crazy, but that's okay. But I'm serious. If you do not get the message, please call me. Call me. Say, hey, I'm still in school. I haven't heard anything about the scholarship. Because this is the first time we only had 15. And when I surveyed the church, I know we had others. I know we did. Maybe they were not in church and the pastors didn't do. We want to encourage our children. We would have excused that this year because we've been in the pandemic, but we would have encouraged them to get back in there and work. Okay? So go forth, do great, but take the Lord with you. Have your light shining so your surrounding students will know that something special about you, and they want to be like you. Mm-hmm. I know my granddaughter wore somebody out with prayer, asking for prayer, and every time she got ready for a test, and it hurt my feelings one time, she called and she used to say, please pray for me. It's not easy. They were in the pandemic, and then after they came out, she still wanted to pray. She said, pray for me, because I'm getting ready for a tough test, and it's not a exam or whatever. It's not easy. And once she told me that she takes me for prayer, and Papa for prayer, and Richardson. And when she just asked him, she got a better grade. I said, from now on, you call. You call him, go text him. If you get a bill pray for him, you go with him. But she wore the knees out of, I want to thank you myself, Reverend Reginald Morton and Reverend Carnette Morton took on my grandchild,
amen,
took care of her like we would have if we were in.
Amen.
She had a black child. She called, two needed a key. Every day, bitch, she called Reverend. Baby, don't worry so much. Oh, they don't mind. They don't mind. But thank y'all so much. I was happy with that. And you remember them every month and back. They were called Kevin. Yes, look, I didn't have to kiss. But thank you so much for all that you all have done. Your prayers, and please continue to pray for my social butterfly, the diamond, and my grandson, who's at Clemson. Pray for them. That Lord will keep his called back from a mighty long way. But I want you all to pray for Reverend Curran, who's been in the hospital. Reverend Alicia Smith, who is in the hospital. Alicia came home
she
today.
She went home yesterday.
Yesterday? Okay, she had a major procedure, but pray, you know, that she had also the back on and said no. But she's home, and I pray that she's recuperating. Want you to remember our district officer, that one that works close with me and support everything that I do, and that's Miss Bessie Williams. She's at home and she's recuperated, and she sent me a note coming back. She may see her soon. I'm glad I didn't have to switch her all the way back to wherever she lives. And Sister Ernestine Williams, pray for her. She's getting ready for a procedure next week. Well, it's a lot of sickness, but we know that God is able. So if what he's done for one, he is doing for another. So lift them up in your prayers. Whenever you pray, lift them up. Now we're going to ask you, if you can pray, just pray, let the church say amen. So we can say amen. They want me to say amen.